drives their talent. You see just weaving through lanes there, jumping all the way over from the one lane to the four lane on their brakes hard, and just now stuck in that afternoon traffic here, just squeezing, threading that needle there between those cars. The Glendale Police Department is just trying to keep up at this point, but with the erratic nature of this driver, it's going to be hard to do because those police officers have to put the safety of the public first, and the way this driver is driving, that is going to be hard to do to stay on the tail of this driver. But you can see how this driver is kind of just getting stuck in all this late afternoon traffic, but the police department saying, nope, we are sticking with you. Wow, almost losing control there as he weaved around that car, choosing a different direction there. And this, I could tell you, Courtney, this is one of the craziest pursuits I've seen in some time. This car going about 70 miles an hour through these surface streets, almost losing control there at that intersection where all that traffic was. This is a extremely dangerous pursuit.
Colton, Micah Ullman here with you as well. And as we watch this become increasingly dangerous on surface streets, oftentimes law enforcement will actually back off and try and calm things down. It doesn't appear at this point that these officers are willing to do that.
That's right. And what we're hearing is that, you know, backing off of this pursuit hasn't really seemed to slow down this suspect. This suspect is simply wanted for a traffic violation starting probably 30 minutes ago. And it's just the suspect has just kept driving quite erratically since then. You could see it kind of doing that loop there through that residential area. Luckily, not a lot of people. So just, wow, just missing those cars into that power line there. Wow, okay. That is quite the ending to this pursuit. We sure hope that this suspect is okay. Now the police have to figure out how to secure the situation. You have down power lines, and they're gonna have to protect the public there too. So they're gonna take this slowly. They're gonna call fire and ambulance services to the area to stage for when they get this suspect out of the vehicle. But right now with that armed and dangerous kind of want out for this suspect, it's going to be a slow process to make sure that the suspect isn't going to harm any of the officers or the public. You can see they have a canine unit out as well. So if this suspect comes out and decides to run, which would be hard to do after that type of impact, that canine officer is there and ready to take the suspect into custody.
Three people
so far coming out of that vehicle. First person there being taken into custody by those officers. You see the air unit overhead calling out this to the dispatchers, and you see the person behind the vehicle there laying down on the ground, throwing that phone out of the way. The second four people, wow, another person coming out of that car too. It's amazing that these people can move after that accident there. But one, two, three, four, two in custody, the other two proned out on the ground, and they're just going to keep calling these suspects back as they kind of have the opportunity to. It doesn't look like this point that all of these suspects are injured in a way where they can't move. It's hard to tell right now from our angle to see how that driver is doing, possibly a passenger now that looking at that vehicle is doing, kind of sticking their arms out of that that door over there. But the police department's taking this one by one suspect, one by one, to take them into custody after this this huge crash here, taking down a power line into a tree. Luckily, no civilians or the public was injured, but there you go. They're gonna take that fourth person into custody, standing up, walking slowly back to those officers. This is what they want to see as they take these suspects into custody. Very slow movements. They're going to check the suspect for weapons, take them into custody, and then they're also interviewing all these different suspects to make sure there's no one else in the vehicle. There's number five coming out of the vehicle. So a lot of people in that very small Toyota vehicle there, and luckily they're all moving well. You see that last person there just said, hey, I'm done. I'm going to come over. I'm going to put my hands behind my back. And I'm ready to be taken into custody, but those officers still poised to make sure that they can clear that vehicle and make sure that it is safe and this situation is wrapped up here in the Los Feliz area here, just to the west of the 5 freeway to the, south of, this is actually Echo Park, my bad. And so now you're gonna see the officers here come together, and they're going to approach the vehicle and clear it, Micah.
There it is again. Sorry, Courtney. As we see on screen, right, a replay of this crash, and a minor miracle, frankly, that no one was hurt, either bystanders or anyone in that car. Look at that.
This happened at an Arco gas station right there. Can you imagine just being pumping gas and seeing this all go down? And amazingly, five people got out of that vehicle and seemingly looked okay, that they were able to walk out unhurt.
And it looks like they've cleared the car.
It's quite amazing that those suspects made it out of the vehicle. It looks like they're clearing that car. You can see how the officer's kind of poise has changed. And they're still going to make sure that they get able to look in that trunk and everywhere. But for the most part here, it looks like they're calling this code 4, that the scene is clear, the scene is safe. And now they're going to have to call in the utility companies, the fire, the paramedics to check out those suspects and take care of now this down power line here in the Echo Park area.
Yeah, again, a small miracle. No one was hurt. Bystanders appear safe and the power lines are down. Avoid the area in Echo Park. We're back with the news at 6 at the top of the hour. Stay with us.
You see there, the moments after that incredible pursuit that ended in an